Hi friends, today we are going to study briefly about the role of vitamins in the human body. Vitamins are called as one of the very important nutrient factors which are very much required for the normal growth and development of the young ones and also for the maintenance of health in case of adults. So these vitamins are mainly derived from the plant derivatives and also from the microbial origin. And these are not produced by the human beings, so supplementation of vitamins are very, very essential for the normal growth and development of the human body. And they are required in very small quantities. Even though the requirement is very small, the inability of the person to take those in the food causes a deficiency manifestations. The important deficiency manifestations are related to each particular vitamin. And so, let us study briefly about the important vitamins which are required for the human body. The vitamins which are required for the human body are broadly classified based on their solubility. The vitamins which are soluble in water are called as water-soluble vitamins, and the vitamins which are not soluble in water but soluble in non-polar solvents are called as fat-soluble vitamins. The major water-soluble vitamins include thiamine, riboflavin, niacin, pantothenic acid, vitamin B12 and pyridoxin. And the major fat soluble vitamins includes vitamin A, vitamin D, vitamin E and vitamin K. The major function of thiamine, it is mainly deficiency causes beriberi. The deficiency of riboflavin causes chelosis. The deficiency of niacin causes a disease called as pellagra. The vitamin B12, it is required for the development of neurons, and deficiency causes pernicious anemia. The deficiency of pyridoxin causes megaloblastic anemia. And the fat soluble vitamins, they are A, D, E and K. So as I said, vitamin A is also required for the maintenance of epithelial cells. So, deficiency of vitamin A causes keratinization of these epithelial cells, which leads to the defect in the germinal epithelium leads to reproductive failure. Defect in the epithelium of the respiratory organs causes respiratory failure and so on. So, vitamin D, it is also required for the maintenance of calcium and phosphate level in the body. So, defective absorption or decreased calcium causes rickets. Vitamin E is a very important antioxidant which helps in the eradication of free radicals. Vitamin K, its role as a clotting factor, it helps in prevention of loss of blood by maintaining the clotting procedures. Then coming to the B complex vitamins, one among the B complex vitamin is niacin. Today, let us have a little detailed discussion about niacin. So, niacin is one of the B complex vitamin. So, it is called as pellagra preventing factor of Goldberger, because the scientist Goldberger, who has invented the disease called pellagra, and he found out that a chemical substance, that is niacin, its deficiency causes this disease. Structurally, a niacin is a pyridine derivative, and it is called as pyridine 3 carboxylic acid. It is also present in two different forms, aldehyde form and amino form. Aldehyde form is called as niacin and amino form is called as nicotinamide. The normal requirement of niacin per day varies from individual to individual. The normal adults who require about 15 to 20 milligram of niacin per day, and for pregnancy and lactation the requirement is slightly higher, that is around 22 to 25 milligrams per day. The major dietary sources which supplies niacin for the human body is mainly a liver, yeast, whole grains, cereals and pulses. These are the very good sources of niacin. And the outermost layer of the cereals and also the pulses are the very good sources of niacin. And it is also available in the animal sources, that is milk, fish, egg are very moderate sources of niacin. coenzymes of thiamine. The major function of thiamine is its role as a coenzyme. This coenzyme is required for the metabolic reactions of carbohydrate, protein and lipids. The major two coenzymes of thiamine are nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide and nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide phosphate, that is NAD plus and NADP plus. The major functions of these coenzymes in the metabolism can be studied under three groups, that is the coenzyme which is required for for the actions, that is NAD plus dependent enzymes, the lactate dehydrogenase, the reaction where it comes in glycolysis where lactate is converted into pyruvate reversibly, and a pyruvate dehydrogenase which converts pyruvate into acetyl-CoA. Glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate dehydrogenase also comes under glycolysis where the glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate is converted into 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate, and the reactions which comes under lipid metabolism, that is beta oxidation, that is the reaction beta hydroxyacyl-CoA dehydrogenase, and the reaction catalyzed by the enzyme alcohol dehydrogenase requires niacin in the form of NAD plus, and the enzyme alpha ketoglutarate dehydrogenase which comes under a glycolysis also requires this NAD which gets oxidized into NADH plus H plus. And the niacin, it is required as a coenzyme NADP plus. There are only two enzymes which requires NADP plus as a coenzyme. Both the reactions which comes under hexose monophosphate shunt pathway. A glucose 6-phosphate dehydrogenase, the very first reaction of HMP shunt pathway where a glucose is converted into glucose 6-phosphate, which is converted into gluconate, where the NADP is converted into NADPH. And another reaction in the oxidative phase of HMP shunt pathway where the 6-phosphogluconone dehydrogenase is the enzyme which requires this NADP plus. And the enzyme NADPH dependent enzyme, that is beta ketoacyl reductase and HMG-CoA reductase, also requires NADPH as a coenzyme. Deficiency manifestations of niacin. The major disease which is caused by deficiency of niacin, it is called as pellagra. Pellagra, it is also called as a 3D disorder, which is 3D means it is characterized by dermatitis, diarrhea and dementia. A dermatitis is a condition where there is an inflammation of the skin takes place. Mainly the major areas of the body which affected by the deficiency of this niacin is a neck, ankle and foot. And the second major symptom of pellagra, it is called as diarrhea, where there is excretion of loose stools, mucus and blood, and also which leads to loss of body weight, and that is called as diarrhea. A third major symptom of deficiency of niacin is dementia. Dementia is causes a loss of memory, anxiety, irritability, insomnia and poor memory. This is mainly found in the aged individuals, and the major symptom, this is loss of memory, that is called as dementia. Then it is, this niacin is also produced from amino acid tryptophan. Even though it can be synthesized from the tryptophan, it requires a very large amount of tryptophan for the synthesis of 1 milligram of niacin. So 60 milligram of tryptophan synthesizes only 1 milligram of this niacin. So moreover, this tryptophan being a essential amino acid, so if we supply niacin instead of producing the same within the body by using tryptophan, we can also save the quantity of tryptophan which is required for other functions of body protein synthesis. So overall, to conclude, niacin is one of the very important B complex vitamin required for the normal functioning of the human body, The major functions of niacin that includes the production of two important coenzymes, that is nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide and nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide phosphate. These two coenzymes are very widely required for the metabolic reactions that involves the metabolism of carbohydrates, proteins as well as lipids. As I said, the deficiency of niacin causes a disease called pellagra. So prevention of this disease required required amount of supply of this niacin regularly, and for adults it is around 20 to 25 milligrams per day. The requirement is slightly higher in pregnancy and lactation. Thank you very much.